I want to thank God. Now say greetings and welcome everybody back today with us to the program. And we're going to be asking the saints of God, to, if you got a Bible, to be sure to stay with me in this week's messages. I'm especially going to be speaking now concerning the times that the Bible said and the seasons that not only God ordains, but we're seeing also men that has perverted the gospel. And Paul warned them in the book of Galatians when he seen some people being removed from him, Jesus, that called ye into the grace of Christ to another gospel. And he said, which is not another, but there be some that would trouble you and would pervert the gospel of Christ. And Paul said, but though we or an angel from heaven preach any other gospel unto you than that which we preached unto you, Paul said, let him be accursed. And he said, as we said before, so say I again, if any man preach any other gospel unto you than that we have preached, he said, let him be accursed. Now, we're going to be showing you, children, that in the time of the Roman Empire, and in the days that Daniel began to foretell and prophesy of the fourth beast that come up on earth, that it was given into the hand of this king to change the times and the laws. And that's already been done. And even here in America, we see it just about every year where we're changing our time. We're putting an hour ahead and an hour behind. And these things, children, is natural seasons and times, but also I'm going to show you that you've got ministers today that are transformed ministers, not of Christ though, and they are trying to put the Word of God into their place and into their means, especially when it comes to prophecy. And especially when we're speaking about the coming of the Lord and also the deity of Christ. You can see how they have moved the Word of God out of its place and trying to put it into their places, and that's why that God is hard against this generation. Now, children, you're facing an hour of great troubles, but I'm going to show you now that everything God said in this Word, He puts it in His time. And when you see ministers, especially concerning the second coming of the Lord, and they begin to move that out in the future to their places and try to maybe take things out and add things to the Word of God, then I'm afraid you can say that we're seeing this time of trouble that Daniel began to write, and so did the prophets. So let me get into the book of Daniel here with you. And I want to read a little bit especially about the fourth kingdom upon earth, which was the Roman Empire. But events had happened at that time, and Daniel foreseen it. But also, children, you need to beware of men today. And they've got big degrees. They're called doctors and doctors of theology, philosophy, and all of these things, traditions. We need to be careful, children, because if the blind is a leading the blind, then they're both going into the ditch. So we're going to be showing you now, and I'm including me or anybody else. If I teach to you the coming of the Lord the second time, and I try to teach His returning contrary to what Jesus said and the apostles, then children, you better believe that's deception. And because people won't receive the love of the truth, God's allowing that strong delusion that they should believe a lie, that they all might be damned, because they would not receive the love of the truth. So it's very important that we give earnest heed to these men of this Bible. So today, if you will, let's just begin out the book of Daniel, about the seventh chapter. And you read it all when you get time, but I'm going to start it at verse about 23 here. And listen, as Daniel's speaking about the fourth beast upon the earth, fourth kingdom and so forth. And it said in verse 23 of Daniel 7, thus he said, the fourth beast shall be the fourth kingdom upon earth, which shall be diverse from all kingdoms, and shall devour the whole earth, and shall tread it down and break it in pieces. And the ten horns out of this kingdom, which are 10 kings, that shall arise, and another shall arise after them. Now, of course, this is time of Rome. Watch this. And he shall be diverse from the first, and he shall subdue 3 kings. And he shall speak great words against the Most High, and shall wear out the saints of the Most High, and think, listen to this, and think to change the times and the laws. And they shall be given into his hand until a time and times and the dividing of times, which is 3.5 years. Now, this king that the Bible is speaking about here, of course, a lot of this time of Rome, they were given into their hand to change the times and the laws. Now, that is the beast or the kings and the kingdoms of the earth. But I want to show you, children, that it's a happening also among the supposedly Christian movement, where you've got multitudes of ministers today that are taking the Word of God and moving it out of its place and putting it into their place. And they also are trying to change times and make the Word of God of no effect by their own traditions. And that's where Jesus warns you that if these blind leaders lead the blind, they're all going into the ditch together. So we're going to be showing you what's happening, but let me show you something here also out of the book of Ecclesiastes, and about the 3rd chapter. Now, remember what Paul said in the book of 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. He said, "Brethren, of the times and seasons, you have no need that I write unto you." See? He let us know that the day of the Lord would come like a thief in the night. So that means God has got a way for His second returning. Now, He's already come the first time, Jesus did, and died on that cross. And of course, He was resurrected, received back into heaven, and He came back to earth on the day of Pentecost in the Spirit. And children, I know people don't understand it or believe it, but that's when He set up His kingdom. And Paul called the kingdom of God righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. See? Now, we need to understand, because when He came back in the Spirit, God said, "I'm going to walk in them." And that means we're His temple now. But the second coming, He'll come in the clouds of heaven as He went away. Jesus arose from the dead, ascended back in the same body that died. But now in Revelation chapter 1 and verse 7, the Bible said, "Behold, He cometh with clouds." So that's in your future. "And every eye shall see Him, and the man that pierced Him is going to look up on Him, and all kindreds of the earth are going to wail because of Him." So children, when Jesus comes, listen to me, this next time, He's not sneaking in here like 90% is being taught. He's coming in flaming fire, taking vengeance on them that don't know God and that obey not the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. But He is a coming also to be admired in all them that love Him. So I'm going to be showing as we're going on that when people is trying to separate the second coming and trying to bring a 2 resurrections, one for the Christians at what they call the rapture of the church, and then later on they're going to have the final judgment as a final resurrection. So they're separating. And I'm going to show you that's moving God's time. And they're trying to do this by their own means. But children, I'm going to show you that the Lord's going to confound this. And every one of us is going to meet Jesus at the judgment, and He'll judge you according to what you're teaching these people. Now, let me show you something here. Because in the book of Ecclesiastes, about the 3rd chapter, listen concerning time, purpose, and seasons that God has. First of all, in the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 3, verse 1, "To everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under the heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted, see? A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to break down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to get and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to cast away. A time to rend and a time to sow. A time to keep silence and a time to speak. Notice everything God said, a time. Now watch this. A time to love, a time to hate. A time of war and a time of peace. So, what this book is telling us here, there's a time and purpose for everything under the heavens, children. And if you remember in the book of Job, I believe about the seventh chapter, Job said, is there not an appointed time for man upon this earth? If you remember in the book of Hebrews chapter 9, Paul said, as it's appointed unto men once to die. Listen to me. But after this, the judgment. You understand that? It's appointed unto men once to die. But after this, the judgment. And this same Paul in Hebrews 9 said, so Christ once bare the sins of many. And unto them that look for Him shall He appear the second time, not the third. Without sin unto salvation, that means He's not coming to be made sin anymore. His body will not be the lamb, but He's coming in power and great glory. And thank God, then only do we get our reward, whether it be good or bad. Now children, why you need to hear this? You've got multitudes of so-called scholars and doctors with degrees, and they're teaching, and they're using other men's sources and teaching you that the next coming of Jesus will be to take the church only out of here, called the rapture, and that we all go to heaven and eat the marriage supper, marry the Lamb and so forth, and then the earth goes through the tribulation, and then they've got us coming back to live on earth for 1,000 years, and then they've got a final judgment after the 1,000 years. Now children, Bible does speak of a 1,000-year reign. But if you don't understand it, you're going to do just like your leaders are. Put it out of its place. And as God is my helper, and I'll get into that as we're going on, the reign of Christ is right now within the church. He lives in His people. He's a ruling on this earth right now in the kingdom. He's not coming again to set it up, but He is a coming one more time to receive the kingdom. And I'm going to be showing you by the Word of God, not mine opinion, that at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ this next time, will it be to separate the judgment from the Christian and let the Christians go on to heaven and then have tribulation so forth on the earth, and this earth just remain right on and on like most people's being taught? I'm going to tell you that answer is definitely no. And we're going to show you what Jesus said in His Word. And while I was reading Daniel chapter 7, it was given into the hands of kings to change the times and the laws. Now you got a warning from God through the apostles and the prophets that in the latter times some would depart from the faith and they would give heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils, which is men in sheep clothing, and they're twisting and changing the Word of God. And children, right now is one of the biggest moves for religious leaders to make wealth and money out of their books or pamphlets, their videos or CDs, selling the supposedly Word of God, and putting the prophecies and the time of the coming of the Lord way out here in the future according to their own means. But I'm going to show you by Jesus. Can He come and get the church at all before the tribulation? And I'm going to show you at His next appearing whether this earth will remain on and on like they're teaching you. Children, it's up to you and me whether we're going to know truth and stand in the evil day. Now listen to me. Trouble's facing you, but also judgment is coming. And Jesus said, the words that I speak, the same will judge you in the last day. Now, it's up to you, it's up to me, to beware of men that come to you in sheep clothing. I'm including me or anybody else. If my teaching and preaching is not corresponding to the Word of God, and if we're trying to give you doctrines that you can't read and call it in between lines or special visions, you better be careful, children. Because I'm going to show you what your Lord Jesus Christ said about His returning. And then it's up to you, it's up to me to receive what He says. But you remember, there's a time and a purpose and a season for everything. And God does His timing. And of course you've got men that want to pervert the timing and the ways of God. Now, I'm going to get into this in just a few minutes in the book of Matthew 24. But there's a few of these so-called doctors out here that are teaching and telling you, listen to me, that there's no end to coming. That time will go on and on. There'll be an end of an age, but this earth will never pass away. Children, if we don't give earnest heed to God and get out of this, I'm afraid this hour of great trouble is going to really do some damage. As God is my helper, when Paul said, put that armor of God on, you need it to stand in the evil day. And if that armor's not representing this book and the way to live by it, I wouldn't know what to tell you. You've got holy men of God who's in this book here, apostles and prophets, to believe on. But yet you've got other men out here building their own Bibles, their own books, and we need to be careful who we're listening to. Now, like I said, I have to teach these things because as it was in the days of Noah, it's here now. And no doubt Noah preached a lot warning the people that there was a flood coming. I'm going to tell you there is an end to coming. And I want everybody to turn with me to the book of Matthew in your Bible, chapter 24. And we're going to begin today. And I want you to listen to the Savior as He began to teach them. Out of the book of Matthew, turn with me, chapter 24. And I'll just go ahead and start at verse about 1. And listen now, this is Jesus in verse 1. And Jesus went out and departed from the temple. And His disciples came to Him for to show Him the buildings of the temple. And Jesus said unto them, see you not all these things? Verily I say unto you, there shall not be left here one stone upon another that shall not be thrown down. Now, He's talking about that temple, Solomon's, and all that great beauty that was built in that temple. Let me tell you something. Your wealth, your beautiful things of the world don't faze God. Whatever He said, it will happen. And when Jesus told them that there shall not be one stone left upon another that shall not be thrown down. Most of you, if you study the Scripture and search out history, you know in 70 AD, Titus, the Roman general, came in here with that army and literally burned the city, destroyed the temple, and eventually there was not one stone upon another, like Jesus said. So when He tells you something, you better believe in His time it's going to happen. No matter who tries to twist it and move it out of its place, it's what I'm trying to show you. You had kings in the old days that changed times and laws, and it's affected us today. But you think you don't have preachers out here today, ministers, that has transformed themselves as ministers of Christ and perverted the truth. And children, they got us believing things that's not biblical. And it's time we open our eyes, because it's the Word of God that the Lord will judge us by. Now, listen to Jesus in verse 3. And as He sat upon the Mount of Olives, the disciples came unto Him privately, saying, "Tell us, when shall these things be? And what shall be the sign of Thy coming, thank God, and of the end of the world?" Now, most people call it end of age. Well, I'm going to leave it to Jesus. He said end of world. Now, in the days of the flood, if you'll remember, Peter said, the third chapter of the book of 2 Peter, concerning the world back in the days of Noah, the people, he said the world that then was, being overflowed with water, perished. Okay? So, the world is a representing people. But I'm going to show you that not only did God say this through the mouth of Peter in the third chapter of the book of 2 Peter, I'll show you, not only did God say that the people in the days of Noah would be overflowed with water and perish, but also God said the heavens and earth were reserved for the future. The day of judgment and the perdition of ungodly men, which meant ungodly men, and that's your final beast stage raising up now. That's going into destruction or perdition. And children, all of this technology, war material, and all of these evils that's getting the mind of your kings is bringing the final beast to the eighth to its head. And children, I'm going to give you the mouth of God Himself, your Lord, that tells you plainly, heaven and earth shall pass away. Peter come on the scene and told you definitely that it would not be a cleaning of the earth, but he said the earth and works that are therein shall be burned up. But you've got 90% of your so-called doctors and scholars in this land of America that's supposed to represent Christianity, but they're twisting, perverting, and they're mockers. Now, I know I'm accused that way too, but as God is my helper, and I'll include me, if I can look in this camera, get on radio or satellite or any means, and tell you that there's no end of coming, and that this earth you're standing on is abiding forever, you can better believe, you can say there's an Antichrist spirit in that man. Now, children, I'm going to show you by God's Word and these great men of God here in the Bible. They're going to back up Jesus when He said heaven and earth shall pass away. Well, you've got multitudes and a lot of scholars, they call themselves, doctors, walking Bibles, perverting the Word of God. And when they come to certain scriptures that's against their theory and their teaching, they'll say, well, that was mistranslated. It shouldn't be in here. See, they do that to pervert. But what about you and me? What if you're giving heed to them? Is that all right? Because you're not the one preaching it. Well, I'll tell you what Jesus said. If the blind lead the blind, He didn't say one's going in the ditch and the other into glory. He said both shall fall into the ditch. And I'm going to show you in 2 Thessalonians, if we don't receive the love of this truth that we can be saved, G-O-D, your God, will send a delusion, a misleading spirit that will help you believe a lie if you don't want the truth. Children, God knows I don't believe we got the time to play around. We're coming to the end. And I'm giving you what Jesus told them when they began to want to show Him all the beauty of the temple, Solomon's. And Jesus told them not one stone would be left upon another that wouldn't be thrown down. And that happened. It happened in 70 AD. Well, then that means the rest of the prophecies He's saying here has happened and will happen. Some's yet to happen, but I'll show you by the Word of God what Jesus said about His second coming. And the reason I'm calling it the second coming There's no third. It's called the last day. It's a final return of our Lord. And I'm going to let the men of God show you whether you're going to have any time after Jesus returns. I know they're giving you plenty, but I'm going to give you the truth. Watch your Bible. And as he sat up on the Mount of Olives, the disciples came unto him privately, saying, "Tell us, when shall these things be, and what shall be the sign of thy coming and of the end of the world?" And Jesus answered and said unto them, "Take heed that no man deceive you, for many shall come in my name, saying, 'I am Christ,' and shall deceive many." Now I know most of you listening in and watching here, you can agree with that 100%. You can look around and see we got so many denominations, so many branches, and every one of them professing to be of Christ. And most of them teaching that Jesus is Christ. But yet they're deceiving many. So we know that's happened, don't we? Well, watch Jesus. "And you shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that you be not troubled. For all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet." Now, we've had a lot of wars. French wars, you've had a lot of Roman battles. You've had World War I, you've had the Korean Wars. You've had all sorts of World War II and all kinds of wars, and even today in Iraq and all the troubles now. So there's no doubt in you. The Word of God is right there. See, Jesus said you'd hear of wars, rumors of wars, and he said, "See that you be not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet." So see, we've seen a lot of that, and it still is not the end. Now, children, I see my time's about up, so I'm going to have to go off the air today, but be sure to stay with me in our next program. I want to show you God's time and what these so-called scholars has damaged, and it's hurt the whole body of Christ and build up a Babylonian empire, spiritually speaking. So stay with me in our next program. And children, write us in your prayer requests. And I'm being honest with you, few's are finding the truth, so be one of them, because we're going to have to stand in this evil day. So write us in any prayer requests. If you can help us on the programs, we do need it, because times is getting rough. And we do appreciate you. And we have good praying people. So send any prayer requests. Till I see you again, God bless you. In Jesus' name, amen.
We would like to thank you for joining Brother Rowe and invite you to continue with him in outreach. Your prayers and support will be deeply appreciated. If God leads you to help in this ministry, please send your contributions to The Church of Jesus Christ, Post Office Box 283, Baxter, Kentucky 40806. And may God bless you. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday and today and forever. The Church of Jesus Christ presents Pastor and Evangelist Pete Rowe.
Thank you, Jesus. All right, I want to say greetings now. I want to welcome everybody back to the program today. I do appreciate the Lord Jesus for all of His people listening in. I hope you've been with us in our last few programs. I'm especially speaking now about the time and purpose of God. And truly, children, I want to be showing you there's no doubt anywhere in the Bible concerning the coming of our Lord Jesus. And most Christians now do believe that He will return.